Hi, I'm Dr. Pruner, and today we're going to be talking about the post-op shoe, something that if you've been to a podiatry office, you probably know what this is. So I'm going to teach you on how to put it on, things to look for if it's not the right fit, and how to properly walk in it. So this is the post-op shoe, a pretty common thing that we use in any kind of foot and ankle injuries slash surgeries for the recovery period. This is the Darko brand. It's a pretty common brand, but most of them are pretty similar, so you don't need to focus on that. There's a couple of features that I want you to pay attention to that we're going to go over today. Number one is the straps and how to apply them. Especially, we'll pay attention to this one right here, as well as the length of this one here. Additionally, we're going to look at the bottom. As you can see, the special thing about a post-op shoe is that you're not going to get any bend here. And if it is bending, get rid of that shoe. It's not the right one for you. This is meant to keep you completely rigid through your foot whenever you're walking. And additionally, it's got this nice little rocker bottom here, or at least nicer post-op shoes do. Some of them are completely flat, just a cheaper version, but it can accomplish the same goal. But if you're someone that's gonna be walking, you know, on the borderline of more than they should be in this post-op shoe, this little rocker bottom will just give you more ease, and it may actually be the thing that makes you feel better whenever you're walking in it. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to show you how to put this shoe on. So there's two straps here that we're looking at. There's the two sides and the one. Just open the one side. Doesn't really matter because we're going to be adjusting both regardless. And then over here, you're going to lift up this strap and open it up. Now, a lot of different shoes have different versions of this. This one's a little bit nicer because it's got this little felt pad to kind of protect your ankle, but all of them have this little piece of Velcro here that you're gonna attach here. And I'm gonna show you a trick in just a second. So open it up, put your foot in, and this is the most important thing whenever you're getting fitted for the shoe. You want your toe to have space, just like a normal shoe, of about a thumb's width. Now, if you are a post-op patient, and let's say you have a pin sticking out of your toe, if that pin is sticking out further than this shoe, you need the next size up. Don't leave with an improperly sized post-op shoe. So this is appropriately sized. I've got that thumb width right here. So that's going to protect me if anything tries to hit me in this direction to not cause any further harm. So the next thing you're going to do is strap it. So you can just place it nice and comfortable. It doesn't need to be too tight. And depending on how bulky bandages are, how much swelling you have, maybe a little bit tougher to adjust. So that's what these are for. So what you can do is instead of adjusting that one, you can place this here, and this you can actually get directional stability. So you can lift it right there to secure around your pinky. And let's say this one has a little bit more swelling. You can make that one a little bit looser, and now it's gonna contour to your foot to keep you better secure. So then the next one is this strap here. Now they make this purposefully longer than anybody's foot is actually that length. And that's for a reason. Everyone's foot sizes differently. Everyone swells differently. So whenever you're putting this on, you're going to adjust here. This is a nice, like I said, little cushion strap. It'll make it more comfortable to wear. But whenever you tighten it, this is the one that you want to be the more secure one, because that's going to keep your foot back. It's going to keep you from shifting, and it's going to keep you from having it loosen whenever you're walking around in the post-op shoe. So you give a nice compression here and you come around. Now you see all this extra flap here, literally meant for you to cut with a scissor around to fit directly to your foot type. You don't need to have all that extra flimsy stuff around. Just trim it off. It's your shoe anyways. Make sure that it fits well and you're not going to trip on something that's dragging on the floor. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how different ways to walk in a post-op shoe are. Now, depending on what your condition is or diagnosis is or what surgery that you've had, your doctor is going to give you certain instructions, and it's very important to adhere to the walking instructions that they give you, or they won't give you any walking instructions at all, meaning that you're going to be full non-weight bearing, and it's very important to adhere to those instructions. So the most common walk that you're going to do with a post-op shoe is a stride. And that's, you know, once you're transitioning from a surgery, or let's say you have a stress fracture that's starting to heal, there's a number of different ailments that would lead to you needing to walk in a post-op shoe. So first things first, after you've had it secure onto your foot, you're going to stand, okay? And so once you stand, you're going to feel that strap loosen a little bit just because it's, you know, you're putting your weight now down, so it's going to feel a little less tight. So what I'm going to do is for me, I can adjust it like this, make it a little bit tighter just to feel it secure. I can even adjust it like this, or I'll pull that in just to get a little bit more tightness there. And then for this strap here, I'm going to also adjust it and give it a little bit more of a pull. So now I feel much more secure in my shoe. So I'm for my stride, like this shoe demonstrates, it's got this little rocker bottom here that's going to allow for me to kind of glide forward. And that's what you want it to do, is you just allow yourself to glide with that rocker bottom. So you're just going to take a step and let it push off heel to toe, heel to toe, and you let it glide. Don't put too much weight down on that shoe. If you're taking it and you're putting weight just like this down on it, you're defeating the purpose of the glide, so that you're not putting too much pressure on the bones or the joints or the ligaments or tendon that you're trying to offload. So the next walk that I'm going to demonstrate is the heel walking. Now, for heel walking, it's very important to understand that this is not comfortable. This is a position that you're not supposed to walk in, which means that if you're doing heel walking and that's what your doctor has instructed you to do, then you need to decrease your activity in order for this to not injure other things like your tendons up here or cause any kind of cramps, hip, knee, back issues. It is meant to slow you down. So I'm going to show you how to properly do this without the risk of harm or injury or tripping over yourself. So this boot again has that little divot right there, so it makes it a little bit easier, okay? So whenever you walk, think of a pirate with a wooden peg leg. So whenever you take a step, heel out, step, heel out, step, heel out, step. It's good to keep your knee pretty straight so that you stay completely off of the front of your foot. Now, let's say that you had a bunion surgery and you need to stay off of that so that your screws don't break. That's how you walk. Let's say that you are non-weight bearing and you can't put weight down on this foot, but your doctor says that if you need balance, that you can use your heel for balance. This is what it means. Let's say you're walking over and you need to get onto, let's say, a commode. So you're non-weight bearing, you've gotten off your crutch, you're going to balance and sit. And now you have not injured yourself. You've put your weight on this leg, you've used your heel for balance, you haven't fallen, and you've protected your surgical site. So if you have any other questions about the post-op shoe, also known as the surgical shoe, give your doctor a call. Don't rely on the internet, especially for something like this, to answer your questions. It's important that you discuss with your doctor, if you're in a device like this, that they know what you're trying to do or what questions that you have. I hope this video was educational for you. And if you have any other questions and you're in the DFW area, feel free to give us a call at Foot and Ankle Associates of North Texas.